It was bombed and abandoned because of war, which means the only people here are us and our cameraman. At least that we know of.
So I guess we start off by getting off the roof?
But we knew that our first objective was to explore this city and find a safe place to call home for the next 7 days, which starts with exploring this building.
All right, let's see what's down the bottom of the building. I assume under this wood is a floor.
Only one way to find out!
All right, this is great.
I feel like I'm in a zombie apocalypse. This is wild.
Oh, look at that.
After a little more exploring, we stumbled across an area that might work for our shelter.
Oh my gosh. I think this is where we should set up camp. You can see the entire city over here. Plus, we have a roof to protect us from rain.
Wow.
And now that we had our home base decided, the next step was to open up the supply crate left by the helicopter on the roof.
Pop open this crate so we can build camp.
We need some gear.
This crate contains all the survival gear we'll need for the next 7 days.
And do we have to carry stuff all the way down the stairs? We're just gonna drop it.
We're on bed duty. Chris got started on making a fire with Mark.
I'm personally a fan of the log cabin when it comes to fires, Eagle Scout. Did I mention that yet?
While me and Chandler look for something to sleep on.
This little mattress was from like 100 years ago?
Hey, you found a mattress?
Yeah.
Where?
On the second floor in the corner. That's all you.
Hey, you should wrap that thing in a tarp so you don't get destroyed by bugs.
I'm gonna wrap that mattress like a burrito. And while Chandler took his chances with this sketchy mattress, the rest of us decided to sleep on wooden doors.
There's no shot that you're more comfortable than me right now. My back already hurts.
There are so many buildings we have yet to explore in the city. Tomorrow's gonna be insane. We'll see you in the morning. Even though our first day in the city went pretty smooth, something eerie did happen to occur later that night. While we were sleeping, Mark and some of the camera guys woke up to the sound of breaking glass not far from the camp. Which made us start to wonder if we were really alone inside the city.
What was it?
I saw something.
But on top of the freaky noises, this shelter was way too windy to sleep.
How'd you guys sleep?
Bad.
So in pursuit of better sleep, we got up, got breakfast, and got prepared to find our new shelter.
Hey, this is the first time I've had chili for breakfast, but I'm so hungry I kinda don't care.
Well, since the raft.